titled Yoga for Transition. So in each class, we add a bit of different types of asana, different type of yoga practices, meditation, breathing, connection. Some of my background is in one-on-one connection, some at times knowing the person that you're connecting with and at times not. So for instance, the first yoga class, or the first class we did for transition was severance, and everyone stood up and the music began. We began walking around the room, and when the music stopped, we connect eyes with someone that is standing closest to us. And you know, it helps us identify that we're not in this alone, and everyone's going through something, and we have an opportunity to connect with that person intimately. So we may find that as a practice. In our second threshold class workshop series, we went from a very active movement of asana at whatever pace that was for you to a sitting meditation, and we did that in a rotation from movement to sitting, from movement to sitting. So in every class there is a chance for connection, for meditation, for breathing, for asana, and to deepen our understanding of how we are working through transition on and off the mat. So, yoga for transition is for anyone. When we're in class and doing, working through the asana practices, we start at a very beginning, very basic pose, and everyone has the opportunity to move up from there to whatever edge that is for you. So it is for anyone who would like to come and participate in the understanding of what transition looks like, of what rites of passage look like, and how we relate to it on and off the mat. We find yoga for transition. We find transition everywhere. We can see it in the change of the seasons. From winter to spring to summer to fall, there are things that are changing in our environment, in our world, and within us. Transitions happen at all times in our lives, right? And we can find them in many situations of our existence. We can find them in loss of loved ones. We can find them in rites of passage such as graduations or marriages. These are very traditional modern rites of passage. And transition. So it is, as you come onto your mat, probably very possible that even if you don't come into class with an idea of what transition you are working with, that one will come, that you will find one sitting there as we get into that place of meditation, as we get into that place of deepening our understanding of severance, threshold, and reincorporation. Yeah, I always encourage people to write. Especially to, you know, go home after the experience and identify possibly where you are moving. One of the beautiful things about transition is that when it's rooted in rites of passage or ritual, it has the potential to lead us into a transformation that increases our quality of life. So join us for Yoga for Transition, third Saturday of the month. Nope, it's not even the third Saturday. It's the third Sunday. Ha 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 ha!